is the first place I learned to speak English. So it holds a lot of history for me. When I do my different music, I meet a lot of different people. The fact that people come here to fulfill their dreams, and so they have this energy about them that's just so contagious. Philippines. I came out to Los Angeles when I was 5, and when I was little, I would love to dance. Running Man, whatever I could do, I was just dancing, and I loved it. I loved every minute of it, and that was how I learned how to speak English. My first memory of music was Michael Jackson's Beat It and Richie Valens' La 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 Bamba, and just, you know, my mother always playing music just because she knew that, oh, like, Liberty's picking up on English this way, so let me introduce her to some more music. And yeah, those were like my beginning memories.
Yeah.
Okay. Okay, just one time around.
Cool. Second verse, or you want me to go third?
Second, and then back to first, second.
Thank you, you guys. Seriously, thank you.
People in my head telling me what they think, but it still doesn't help the position I'm in. Pops in the Philippines, mom's disappeared. G-mom's tripping, I ain't going to school for nursing. She said it's a waste of time doing that rap thing. When you gon' learn to realize it's not worth it. Maybe cause of fact my mom's left without notice. I got a bit of hostility and I'm rebellious. But some things I'm not willing to do. Living a life with someone else's I just can't do. Still, it doesn't change how much I love you. I wanna live my life and be happy too. This thing like this, I need to clear my head, get a chance to meditate, get ready.
It's so special to me because it's so empowering. You know, it's so inspiring to me because you see different artists like Lil Wayne come from New Orleans where it's so hard to move forward, and you know, like the setting's just pretty rough, like how it is in the Philippines. Rubble, dirt, not a lot of space, not really modernized. And to see someone come from that kind of environment and now be someone's, you know, inspiration to do better things, it's an inspiring movement. You know, it makes you want to be a better person. It moves you, it encourages you when you're feeling down. When I listen to hip hop, I could listen to Kanye West's Touch the Sky and, you know, I feel like a whole new person because it's like, yeah, I want to touch the sky.
I'm gonna keep hustling till I get to the top.
Like this,
I gotta clear my head, get a chance to meditate, get ready for the next day.
Fly away, fly away.
You made some of the ad-libs on it, huh? Cook food, lay back, no arguing. And I don't wanna hear no phones ringing. I just wanna be in my bed chilling, hearing a bluebird singing like.
Love life, though you're living in the hood. Never let the bad outshine the good.
That guitar makes you feel some kind of way, doesn't it?
Cool. And one, two, three.
I just wanna fly away.
Frank Sinatra, Kanye West, the list goes on. I mean, I just take from each genre of music, each artist I really admire. And those were just a few to list. But, you know, I just take from all of those different styles and just leaves me open to, you know, a whole different world when I create music. I just take from all those different experiences I have with different people. You know, you just get so inspired about it because you're like, yo, this is magical. I believe that it's evolved in different ways, but I definitely don't think it's dead. I still think it's very much alive. If you look at people like Sean Combs, Jay-Z, 50 Cent, I mean, they made hip-hop a lifestyle that people really admire. Hip-hop's empowerment for me.
Hi, Mom. You know, my grandmother wasn't really into me rapping. She wanted me to be a nurse. Rest in peace to my Jima. And we still doing it. God is good all the time.
Performer would probably be my performance for the 15th anniversary of ABS-CBN, which is a big Filipino network. And you know, that experience was just so memorable because I've never seen so many of my Filipino people in one building. You know, it was so many people that fire marshals were there, and it was just over capacity. The energy was crazy. And you know, Filipino people, we just love to dance, we love to sing, we just love the arts, we love entertainment. And to meet so many different artists, to meet Charisse Pimpango, to meet different actors, just do their thing, it was just so phenomenal for me. And it changed my life as an artist. It really forced me to dig in and ask myself, how else can I evolve? How can I appeal to my people and let them know I'm not fully Americanized, you know, that I still have my culture, that I carry it in my heart.
Excuse me, cause I get a mixed statement. Can't stop some clubs that I get tested. My mission's so so good, we twist it. Excuse me, cause I get a mixed statement. Vintage optics, they hurricane, and I can hear the gossip. Mark Jacobs sitting with a cat, I close it. I gotta have it to have it. Sexy, call the contrary, a crime for any time. Scary, necessary, the focus on their mind. Guard the car, killing it any time. Spurring, she broke it, a pin for the crime. Guilty police, so you know this.
My experience with Master P and Nolan, it was definitely unforgettable. You know, I learned a whole nother side of music as far as the southern music goes. It was just really fun. It was a fun experience for me, and you know, it helped build my confidence because I really looked up to Master P, and he was one of those people in the industry that, you know, really made a way for himself and helped different people. So for a person in that position to really believe in me meant so much to me. Well, you know, every day is a process. I definitely feel closer than I did when I first dropped my demo when I was 15. And, you know, I'm just grateful for every day. I'm definitely in a place in my life right now where I'm evolving in so many different ways, learning different instruments, and really learning how to use the talents that God's given me.
No comparison, I know you're hearing this. R-W-I-N-C, period. Excuse me, cause I gotta make a statement. It's so subconscious that I can taste it. My vision's so subvivid, I can trust it. Excuse me, cause I gotta make a statement.
I definitely want to be one of those people, one of those inspirations for kids to know that they can follow their dreams and that it's definitely possible. Just trying to evolve in the different strengths that I have and also strengthening, you know, things I need to work on. I want to be one of those examples that, you know, really prove that it's okay to follow your dream. You know, follow it and follow it with zeal, because that's definitely what I'm doing.
You know I gotta get it, kid, and I'm so ready. You know I gotta get it, I'm so ready. You know I gotta get it, I'm so ready. Queen Cobra on the mic, I'm so deadly. Excuse me, cause I gotta make a statement. Getting so, so close that I can taste it. Vision so, so vivid, I can trace it. Excuse me, cause I gotta make a statement. You know what kind of kitty, kitty, I'm so pretty.